Hello, today we're going to go over adding and subtracting negative numbers. Let's start with adding. Adding two numbers with the same sign. In my first box here, I have the steps. Step one, add their absolute values. Step two, use common sign. Let's do that. Here I have three examples for the first box. 2 plus 3. We know that is 5, right? We add the absolute values, 2 and 3. Then they're both positive, so that's why it's a positive 5. That works for all numbers, including negative, when you add them. Negative 2 plus negative 3, right? We're going to add the absolute values. The absolute value of negative 2 is 2. The absolute value of negative 3 is 3. So it's the numbers without the sign. 2 plus 3 is 5. And we're going to use their common sign, is negative 5. So what would this one be? Well, negative 11. Again, we're going to add the 5 and the 6 and use the common sign. It makes sense because if you're 5 in the hole plus 6 in the hole, that would give you $11 in the hole. I always like to think of logic when adding negative numbers. So that was adding negative numbers with the same sign. Now let's go over adding two negative numbers or two numbers with different signs. The steps there are going to be to find the larger absolute value minus the smaller one. Step two, use the sign of the larger absolute value. Let's do some examples there. Here's some examples of adding different signs. So here we have a negative 2 plus 3. So I'm going to find the larger absolute value minus the smaller. So 3 minus the 2, because the absolute value of negative 2 is 2. That's 1. And I'm going to use the sign of the larger absolute value. So 3 is larger than 2, so that's why it's positive. This, on the other hand, will be a negative 1, because you still take 3 minus 2, but now 3 is negative. 3 is still larger, but it's now negative. You use the sign of the larger absolute value. So what would this one be? Well, if you take 7 minus 4, it's 3, and the 7 is larger than the 4, so it's negative 3. Finally, how do we subtract two negative numbers? Well, what we're going to do is add the opposite. I'm going to write that down. It turns out that subtracting a number is the same as adding the opposite. Add the opposite. Let's look at some examples there. So 5 minus 4 we know is 1. So my claim is 5 minus 4 is the same as 5 plus negative 4. So we have I'm going to circle that. That's a minus, so that's a positive. So we got to add the opposite. Add the opposite positive 4 is negative 4. So what is 5 plus negative 4? Well, now we can use adding rules. Oh, those are different signs. We're going to use that middle box. So now we know we subtract the numbers. 5 is larger than 4, so it's positive. So you can see that 5 minus 4 is the same as 5 plus negative 4, which both answers are 1. So the trickiest one is this middle one here. A lot of people will think that is 1. But how can 5 minus 4 and 5 minus a negative 4 be the same answer? Well, it's not, because we're going to add the opposite. So we're going to do two circles here, going to change that to a plus, and then the opposite of negative 4 is a positive 4. So subtracting a negative turns out to be adding a positive. So that answer is actually 9 and not 1. Even this, all subtraction we change. So minus a 3, so we have minus a 3 means add the opposite plus a negative 3. So I leave the negative 6 alone, change the minus to a plus, add opposite. The opposite, add, so if I made it add, the opposite of positive 3 is negative 3. Now we can use adding rules again. Negative 6 plus negative 3, well, those are the same sign. So what are we going to do? We're going to add, use the common sign. So that would be a negative 9. So my last example is going to be a combination of three numbers, a student question. So we're going to start left to right, and I'm going to figure out what negative 5 minus 8 is. So just making this larger, it's subtraction. Negative 5, that means a minus because it's between the two numbers at this moment. So I want to change. So I'm going to circle both of those, change both of these. So leave the negative 5 alone. Make the minus a plus because I'm going to add the opposite. And now the positive 8 turns into a negative 8. And we know that negative 5 plus negative 8 is the same sign, right? 5 in the whole plus 8 in the whole is $13, or 13, and it's negative. Use the common sign. It's much easier to think of logic in the addition. If you notice, every time I talk about logic, I talk about it only in the addition, not the subtraction. The subtraction, especially the second one here, with that double negative, it makes it kind of difficult. So that's why I personally always like changing to addition. So again, subtracting two numbers is the same as adding the opposite. So I'm going to circle those, change those two things, leave the negative 13 alone. I'm going to add the opposite. Take the minus, make it a plus. The opposite of negative 12 is positive 12. So what's the answer? It is negative 1. Hope that helps. One more thing I want to say, that the reason that it's negative 1 is because, again, these are different signs. So we know we subtract. 13 minus 12 is 1. 13 is larger than 12, and that's why it's negative. Or just go for logic. Once it's addition, logic is okay. 13 in the whole plus you win 12, you're still down negative 1.